day we celebrate the 19th Sunday in ordinary time. We stand.
We glorify you. We give you thanks for your by the Holy Spirit, we dare to call you Father. Bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. At the mountain of God, Horeb, Elijah came to a cave where he took shelter. Then the Lord said to him, "Go outside and stand on the mountain before the Lord. The Lord will be passing by." A strong and heavy wind was rending the mountains and crushing rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. After the wind, there was an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. After the earthquake, there was fire, but the Lord was not in the fire. After the fire, there was a tiny whispering sound. When he heard this, Elijah hid his face in his cloak and went and stood at the entrance of the cave. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Is the Christ, who is over all, God blessed forever. forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Get into a boat and precede him to the other side, while he dismissed the crowds. After doing so, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. When it was evening, he was there alone. Meanwhile, the boat, already a few miles offshore, was being tossed about by the waves, for the wind was against it. During the fourth watch of the night, he came toward them walking on the sea. When the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified. "It is a ghost," they said, and they cried out in fear. At once, Jesus spoke to them. "Take courage, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter said to him in reply, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat and began to walk on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw how strong the wind was, he became frightened. And beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately Jesus stretched out his hand and caught Peter, and said to him, "O you of little faith, why did you doubt?" After they got into the boat, the wind died down. Those who were in the boat did him homage, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you.
In the Gospel today, there is a little tiny glimpse of a very peaceful, serene image. It's at the very end. Jesus gets into the boat, and the water's calm. The winds die down. You can just imagine that at that point, it was probably felt very still, very peaceful. But what seems so striking is that when he was walking on the water, it was not calm and still and peaceful. He's actually walking in the waters of chaos, rough, tumultuous waters. And so there's a lesson in that for us. That lesson, very simply, is that Jesus is present in the chaos of life. It's not only when things are calm and seem to go well. During the time of Jesus, this ancient period, water was looked at a little differently than we look at it. We just turn the tap and there it goes. We fill our swimming pool with it even, not even just our glass. But in the time of Jesus, water, bodies of water were known to be dangerous and super chaotic places. Fishermen and the sailors knew that it was very dangerous to be out on the water. They took jobs to fish that were known to be highly dangerous, and most of the people didn't swim. Water was for drinking, for watering your livestock, for growing crops, and for gathering fish. It was a necessity of life, not so much the recreational place that I used it for last week. But the disciples are in this environment. This is a very choppy water, very dangerous environment. They're getting quite nervous, and they see something. They're not even sure what it is. You listen to the gospel, they're driven by an assumption that it's evil. They assume it must be bad. They say, it is a ghost. And Jesus tries to calm them. Don't worry, it is I. Do not be afraid. And the immediate reaction is, prove it to me. You prove that to me. I doubt. Notice how doubt continues throughout the story. They doubt in the tumultuous waters of the sea. They're afraid. They doubt when they see this figure coming toward them on the water. What on earth could that be? And they're filled with doubt and assume the worst. And when he says, it is I, do not be afraid, they are still in doubt. Prove it to me. And he immediately says one word, come. So Peter gets out of the boat and he walks across the water to Jesus. Now remember, probably couldn't swim. But he's invited to take that huge step out of his comfort zone to do something miraculous. He's invited to take a risk, not only out of his comfort zone, but probably what he fears may be the end of him, because he probably does not know how to swim. This could compromise his very well-being. Think about that. Even when Jesus is doing amazing things in us, our fears and our doubts keep getting in the way. They keep wanting to steer us away from the Lord. When fear takes hold, when doubt really grips us, we too sink. We stall in our efforts. We freeze, even though we know what is good to do. We fail to achieve. The answer to our doubt is to again cry out to the Lord, just like Peter, Lord, save me. Because Jesus is always ready to catch us. He's immediately present again. We just missed it because we were caught up in our fears and in our doubts. It's only after all of that transpires. Remember, doubt and fear were present several times throughout that story. But after taking that risk, after courageously stepping out of where he felt comfortable, does Jesus actually step into the boat and the winds die and the waters are peaceful? There's another lesson. We like to do it the other way. We want peaceful waters from which we can then make calculated risks. We want to remain in control. But the entirety of this miracle happens in the chaos of the waters, not in the stillness. And sometimes we miss that. So Jesus is going to ask you to take risks for him, for one another, for your family, for your community, for people in need, while you're confused, while you're suffering in the chaotic waters of doubt and fear and insecurities and feeling vulnerable. That's where Jesus performs his miracle. The peace is there, but it almost always comes afterward. Because he doesn't want us to be in control. He wants us to surrender ourselves to his lordship. Today we pray
for this courage, to step out of the boat of our comfort, to step out of the protection, and to step into and embrace the chaos, knowing that Jesus is present.
Together, let us make our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us now offer to our Heavenly Father the prayers and petitions of our community, our families, and those of our hearts.
For Pope Francis, successor of Peter, may God continue to bless him with good health and vitality. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For elected officials, may God graciously watch over them in their service to their people. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those sinking in the waters of pain or fear, may Christ, the divine physician, calm them and grant them peace of mind. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all gathered here today, may the Holy Spirit help us more firmly embrace our faith in a loving God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they be welcomed into the eternal life God gives through his Son. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us pray especially for the repose of the soul of Bill and Alice Mertens, for whom tonight's Mass is offered. For them, that they might rest in the eternal peace of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious and loving Father, as we approach, courageously offering all our prayers on behalf of those in need, we ask that you would receive them, for we make them in faith through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you,
and with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you so loved the world that in your mercy you sent us the Redeemer to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might love in us what you have loved in your Son, by whose obedience we have been restored to those gifts of yours that by sinning we had lost in disobedience. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks as an exaltation we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. John the Evangelist, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing love. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant, Francis our Pope, and Carl our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow in the world all that is good.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
The communion antiphon, on Jerusalem, glorify the Lord.
Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
I would ask you to continue to pray for the two young women of our parish entering religious life on today. Meredith Alvarez joined the Daughters of Our Mother of Peace in Marionville, Missouri. And then next weekend, Teresa Moss will be entering the Immaculate Heart of Mary Sisters in Colwich. So we're continuing to pray for both of them. Also, the virtual town hall meeting is readily accessible on our parish website. You are encouraged to watch that and to send your feedback. We're trying to get a lot of feedback before August 15th. Although I will tell you, there's a building meeting on Monday night. So anything you submit today or tomorrow still makes it to that meeting, and the committee sees everything as you type it. We print off even your mistakes. Typing errors. My lame attempt at humor. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace.
Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into heaven.
Please remain in your pew until the usher dismisses your robe, and following the dismissal, there will be the anointing of the